Hello everyone. So the author I decided to do for my author presentation is Bill Martin Jr. He's actually a very famous children's author. A little bit about him, biography. He was born and raised in, excuse me if I mispronounce this, Hiawatha, Kansas, which I find pretty interesting since college is in Kansas, but he was born March 20th, 1916, and he actually passed away August 11, 2004. A little bit more to add to that is actually going to come when I talk about some interesting facts about him, about his death. He actually had a library named after him, and I'll go over that when I go over the facts. So during World War II, he actually served in the Air Force as a newspaper editor, where he wrote his first book, The Little Squeegee, and he also was known as William Ivan Martin Jr. at the time. He graduated from Northwestern University. That is where, and then after he graduated from Northwestern University, he went to go get his doctoral degree in childhood education, which I think is pretty cool since I am wanting to be a teacher as well. Excuse me, to add to that, he actually earned a master's and a doctoral degree in childhood education. So during his career, he wrote over 300 books. A lot of those are pretty famous, and I have four that I'm actually gonna share with you here. And he's worked with other authors like Eric Carle, which, you know, I have one of his books where he illustrated, Eric Carle did. And then he's also worked with another author called Lois Ellhart. So a few interesting facts about Bill Martin Jr. So he actually wrote his first book, which I don't actually have on hand, but it's the one I was going over in the biography, The Little Squeegee. And his illustrations, which I found interesting, were by his brother, Bernard Martin. And the two actually won an award together for, you know, him writing and his brother illustrating, which I thought was pretty neat. He actually did not know how to read up until he reached college. And when he reached college, he actually went to Kansas State's Teachers College in Emporia, Kansas, which is where he initially learned how to read. Which I thought was pretty interesting too, because now he is an author, and although he is deceased, he's famous now. So what I was mentioning in the biography was actually about how when he deceased, he actually has a library named after him at Texas A&M University Commerce, where he died in Commerce, Texas, which I thought was pretty interesting too. He actually died at the age of 88, so he lived to be 88 years old, so he got a lot of, you know, writing out the way, which was pretty interesting. So he basically wrote for almost 60 years. That's a long time. So today he's actually, although deceased, he's known as America's favorite children's author, which I could say that I agree because he does write very good works. And then also, a little more, he was actually elected into the Reading Hall of Fame by International Literacy Association. So some of his famous works, by Bill Martin Jr., which I have four checked out here, was Brown Bear, Brown Bear, What Do You See? This is a very famous one of his classics, actually. One of my favorites that I like reading to students. Another one would be called Here Are My Hands by Bill Martin Jr. and John Archambault. It's kind of difficult to say there. And then another one of his works is actually his first book, Chicka Chicka Boom Boom, is my favorite. They didn't have that at the library, so I got his second one, Chicka Chicka 123, which is also a good one by Bill Martin Jr. and Michael Sampson and Lois Ellert. And then lastly, another book, Ten Little Caterpillars by Bill Martin Jr. and illustrated by Lois Ellert. So these two are actually Lois Ellert books here, which is interesting. And then this one is by Eric Carle that I mentioned that he worked with. So I'm actually going to read this one to you. Brown Bear, Brown Bear, What Do You See? Brown Bear, Brown Bear, What Do You See? By Bill Martin Jr., pictures by Eric Carle. Brown Bear, Brown Bear, What Do You See? I see a red bird looking at me. see, the pictures are very like bold, vivid colored, and they look like they were collaged onto the pages, which is what I like. Red bird, what do you see? I see a yellow duck looking at me. Yellow duck, what do you see? I see a blue horse looking at me. And if you notice, the colors correspond with the word, so it makes it easier for children to understand as well. Blue horse, what do you see? I see a green frog looking at me. Green frog, what do you see? I see a purple cat looking at me. There's a green frog. Next, we're going to go to the purple cat. Purple cat, what do you see? Their next animal, I see a white dog looking at me. White dog, what do you see? I see a black sheep looking at me. Black sheep, what do you see? I see a goldfish looking at me. Goldfish, what do you see? I see a teacher looking at me. Teacher, what do you see? I see children looking at me. Children, what do you see? We see a brown bear, a red bird, a yellow duck, a blue horse, a green frog, a purple cat, a white dog, a black sheep, a goldfish, and a teacher that's looking at us. That's what we see. See, it just goes over all of the animals in the different colors that it went over. So that's one of his classics that I really liked reading. And I love reading that book to any students that I watch or teach as well. So Bill Martin Jr., I actually included in my PowerPoint some of his book reviews, like on Brown Bear, What Do You See? There's one that said, I started reading this to my daughter shortly after she was born. I found that making the animal sounds while reading enlarged her attention, even as early as a few months. Over time, she's begun to pick up the sounds and make them herself. She's 29 months now and we read this book together. I read words, she makes the animal sounds. Sometimes I even catch her reading the book alone, flipping the pages and making the sounds of each animal. I have several other Carly books and I am a huge fan of all of them. So that's just kind of one of the reviews on Brown Bear, What You See, as I read to him. And then I also included more reviews on the other two books. A little bit more about Bill Martin Jr. here. He's a very famous author, which is why I liked choosing him. So as far as an activity in a response to all of these books, for like Brown Bear, What Do You See? Because this is like for preschoolers learning their colors. I would actually have little cutouts and printouts, not necessarily coloring pages, but you know, where they can possibly cut the shapes out depending on how well developed they are with their motor skills, and have them make mobiles of the animals where they can color, decorate, you know, kind of show their creativity with that. Here are my hands. This one is about body parts. They would kind of do the same thing, or we would have, you know, everybody come up. You know, I would say basically Simon Says with this one as a response to this one. So, Chicka Chicka Boom Boom, I would actually have them do a coconut tree of their own, and then this would help them count their numbers as well. And then this one, I would just have them make a huge caterpillar, like a class caterpillar, and then we write all of our names on it. About my author, he was doing information on him was very good. I had a great time researching about him. I enjoyed everything I read about him, and then I also enjoyed reading some of his works that I checked out. And that was my author, Bill Martin Jr.